So, tell us for our viewers, we want to know about you, first of all, how you became an RJ.
Okay. Journey of becoming an RJ is something that is very interesting, I must say. 2015 November I joined. 2017 July is when my boss called me to his cabin, and he was like, why don't you do a show? Because, like, you know, you have a good voice, you have good personality, and you are giving good content. Why don't you try doing a show by yourself? And my immediate answer was no.
Oh no.
I don't think I want to do that, where I know a lot of people outside are dying to become RJs. And when that opportunity came to me, I said no, actually. And that's my boss. His name is Hari. He is someone who I'll always remember through my career, because he's been that key person who pushed me to it. Then he wasn't ready to give up on me, and he told me, you know what, like, just try doing the links, like, record some links, show it to me, let me see what you got. So I thought, okay, fine, let me try. Like, you know, it's not like I'm becoming an RJ overnight. Let me try. So I started recording links, and he really drilled me through the process, I must say. Like, he gave me the right kind of motivation, and also he was kind of that annoying boss, I should say, but that really helped me. So I think almost 3 to 4 months of training I was going through with him, morning and night. I used to do links. I used to, you know, like, work with him. And then finally in 2017, August, I was launched as an RJ.
Okay.
And I was given a show. And yes, that's how my RJ journey started.
So basically, you can say you become an accidental RJ, right?
Definitely.
Because I have seen this word in your profile as well, accidental actor. Somewhere it's written. I have seen it. What does that mean?
Yes. Accidental actor. Again, I never thought I would become an actor. But now, yes, I have been acting, and I've been given roles. So I think I should call myself an accidental actor. I, of course, like, right from the time I became an RJ, a lot of things started coming my way. Being a voiceover artist, being a dubbing artist, I've started dubbing in movies now.
Okay.
And also, like I just told you, the acting opportunity started coming my way. And first I used to say no to the roles that used to come. Then I thought, you know, like, I should try. Like, let's see what the worst that can happen. Then I gave it a shot, and yeah, that's why I called myself an accidental actor.
I must say, that's the first time I've seen a very good accidental height somebody achieving.
Thank you so much.
Yeah. So, who don't know the concept of Love 919?
Okay, so you want to know the concept of Love 919.
And your attachment with this concept?
My attachment with this concept. So my show, the first show that I ever did is Love 919. And late night show. And the late night show in any radio station, if you see, is a love show.
Right.
And they're not just a love guru type of show where people call me with their problems and I solve it. I'm not a love guru, and I don't have the experience and age to be a love guru as well. So relationships, romantic relationships. My show deals with all sorts of love. Like, you know, we talk about friendships. We talk about love towards your mom, love towards your pets. Basically about anything, life, about life in itself is what we talk about. That's the concept of my show.
Seeing some videos regarding your greet of listeners, right? You have this program that you have done last year, I think, 2019.
Right.
So what is the basic idea behind that?
What's the basic idea behind that is just to meet my listeners, because there are, of course, for a radio jockey, right? Like, you have a different set of listeners every day. And there will be these few people who are religiously following your show on an everyday basis. And, you know, when I talk on radio, when I ask a question, there are these few people who will answer every day, like whatever happens, if I'm having a bad day, if I'm having a good day, and if I ask them a question or if I'm having a contest in the show, these people who are like religiously following me. So I just wanted to take a day and meet all of them personally and just show them how a radio station is, and you know, just take them for a tour and show them this is how a radio station looks like, this is how we work, and this is how just giving them an idea, virtual, like instead of just being on radio and just listening to them, talking to them, I wanted to take them to the station and just spend a day with them. That's what I did.
Oh, that's nice. That's nice to know, because sometimes people need some motivation behind listening somebody being a fan. So that's a very nice thing.
Very true, yeah.
Something about chill corona.
Chill Corona, yes, yeah. That's very dear song to me and all the people who worked for the song. It's just a very random word that we had, right, when it wasn't that serious yet. Like, it was just starting to come to India, and like we were hearing, okay, something called Corona is coming and stuff. And I was just talking to one of my friends, and I was just telling him, let's just do this song, you know, let's just do a song and let's see what, let's just randomly try. And then he took it very seriously, and he started working on it, and he told another friend, and he came on board. He wrote the lyrics, and this one composed, and all of us sang together. That's how the song happened. And we did not think it would blow up in such a big way.
Yeah, big hit.
Yeah, we did it just for fun, and people really took it very like nicely. It was well received, I must say. So yeah, that's how Chill Corona happened.
Which is a favorite celebrity till now that you have interviewed in your show? Because you have done lots of celebrities from Bollywood and all those stuff. So, which is the best one?
Which is the best one? Okay.
Yeah.
I have to think. What's the best one? Suddenly you asked me. I'm not able to think. I think Benny Deol. Benny Deol's interview was actually fun.
Okay, yeah.
It was a fun interview.
And a lot of people have said that.
It was a lot of fun jamming. And also, my friend Abhay Jodhpurkar, he's also a singer. And he's also a very good friend of mine. So, the live session that I recently did with him.
So, you both have sang in that, I think. In the session that you sang, both of you sang something, I think? You sang as well, right?
Yes, we did. Yeah. We did, yes. That was a lot of fun because, yeah, it was more of a friendly conversation than an interview. But it was a lot of fun.
Yeah, I've heard that. So, in an e-magazine called Provoke as well?
Yes.
So, what's that basically? The lockdown, how you work in lockdown, that's the concept basically that you have written there?
Yes, that's so basically Provoke is not an e-magazine, it's an actual lifestyle magazine. It's one of the best magazines, right? And because of Corona, you know, you can't really print copies and everything, so it became an e-magazine. Most of the magazines, right, from Vogue and Cosmopolitan and everything, is going e-magazine during period, because there's no manpower, there's no companies that's like, you know, there's no factories open to actually go and print these magazines. Yeah. They got in touch with me regarding like how an RJ is working from home during Corona. That was the whole question, because even I did not know that until Corona happened, you know, like people can work from, and RJ can work from home. I did not know that. Okay, and a lot of people message me and ask me, is your show still, you know, on air? Is it still happening, or your show is stopped, or, you know, is it not, a radio still going on? Kya? And all that people used to ask me. But through the Corona situation, it's still on. It's still, we all are working from home. And yes, my show is going on air every day, 9 to 12. Every day I'm live, I'm doing my show.
Are you a cricket fan? Are you a cricket fan? Cricket CSK?
Cricket fan, huh? Okay. Honestly speaking, I'm not a very huge cricket fan. But yes, I like the sport. It's a great sport. Like I started watching cricket only after IPL, Chennai Super Kings and all
that.
It was just like fun for me to watch it, but I'm not a very sport watching person. But yeah, cricket's good. Cricket's fun.
Oh, that's nice to know. I have seen your voice is so beautiful. You have sang in different languages. So how does is it getting from your genes or is it just you practiced it? How does your voice is so beautiful when you sing some songs?
Thank you. Thank you so much for that. But yeah, I honestly feel voice is something that's a God's gift. Because right. All other talents, I feel it can be mended, it can be, you can train for it. But voice is something that's truly God's gift, I would say. And but yes, I am a trained Carnatic singer.
I have
trained in Carnatic. But again, it was a very long back. Like when I was in school, I learned Carnatic music. And then I was completely away from singing for a very long time.
Do you have a love life right now or you are just concentrating more on your career right now? This is a question from 4 or 5 of your listeners.
Okay. Yeah. So the answer to the question is I am very much single. I don't have a love life right now. And yes, I am concentrating on career and my family is always there. My family and my friends who are very, very dear to me and who's always been there through my journey. But yes, if I meet someone interesting, why not?
After this interview, I think when it will go there, then there are a lot of people contacting you then.
We'll see.
Yeah. So, if there are any young people who want to be an RJ, so what would be your mantra to them? What would you suggest them? How to become, how to train?
How to become an RJ? Okay. I know for a fact there are a lot of people, there are lakhs and lakhs of people who wants to be in the radio industry. And we have interns in our office who, they come to our office, they start interning and then slowly they go up the ladder. What do I have to say is basically to become an RJ, it's not like you need some qualification or you need to do some major in some kind of, there's no such degree as such. But to become an RJ, I think you need to be very updated on all the things that is happening right now around, you know, in the world. And especially an RJ has a very good connect with the city. So right, whichever city you are from, like, you know, if I'm from Chennai, I should be updated with everything that's happening in Chennai. And RJ always has a local connect with the people. And that's why the listeners also listen to you because I am talking, I get on air one day and I tell them, you know, okay, it's raining in Chennai, which means, yes, the whole Chennai city, it's raining. And that's when I say there is a connect, right?
Right.
And yeah, it's very important to be, locally, be very aware of the local things that's happening. Right. Locally relevant, that's the word that I was looking. Locally relevant and practice your speech because speech is again one thing that's very important to become an RJ. And people tell you that, oh, you're an RJ, that's why you talk a lot. But that's actually a myth. It's not like if you're an RJ, you talk a lot. Make sure your words are clear, you know, that is more important. It's not like you talk pages and pages. You just have to be very clear in whatever you're saying and just, right. Yeah, you follow your passion. And and I think in this age of social media, a lot of people are very, we all are very privileged to have social media. Like it's not really radio is needed or, you know, like you have any, people are putting out, you can be a podcaster because anybody can be a podcaster these days. You have good content. You can put out a podcast in any of the platforms that's available. So just, you can practice, you can be a podcaster, you can be an RJ, you can do whatever you want. There's a will, there is a way.
Last question would be, how do you see yourself after 5 years from now? Do you have any plans or you just randomly select something? Do you have plan for futures or you just say, okay, let's see tomorrow, not so much far ahead?
I'm someone who just goes with the flow, honestly. I really don't have a 5-year plan, 10-year plan at all. I don't know what I'm doing tomorrow. So, I don't know. Yeah. So, I take life one day at a time. And yes, and also being someone from the entertainment industry, it's very you can't really plan. Like now, because you're working from home, corona and everything, you are like, you know, okay, chalo, kuch bhi ho jata hai. But once work starts, it's different, literally different every day. You plan something, but then right. something else happens. So it's better to not plan. So, and definitely, I don't know what I'll be doing in the next 5 years. I don't have a 5-year plan.
Oh, that's nice to know. That's nice. Because I think sometimes you have to go with the flow rather than being planning for a long period of time. Yeah.
Yes. Yes.
So I think you must have liked this conversation for our viewers and for my channel. And it was very glad meeting you and hearing from you.
It was lovely meeting you with it. It was a fun session. I really liked the questions that you asked me. And thank you so much for having me.
Yeah, and I'm glad that you, from your busy schedule, you got a time for us.